Hey yo, today we're going to go over how to determine a parallax angle, but this is not the first video I've made on parallax. If you'd like an explanation of the geometry used to calculate the distance to stars, you can go ahead and check out my previous video. This video is made specifically to answer a question I've seen a lot of people ask on astronomy-related channels, including my own. How do we measure the parallax angle in the first place? I feel like an astronaut in what you know about rolling down in the deep. Let's imagine, very realistically, that we're on Earth looking at a distant star in the sky. We take a picture and notice that the star is in one place on the image relative to the stars behind it. To determine the parallax angle, we need more than just this information alone. We need one more measurement. So we wait 6 months for the Earth to travel to the other side of the sun and take another picture. Now we will see the star at a different place on the image. Okay, so now we have two images that show how the star we are observing has shifted places. How does this correspond to an angle? For this, we look to a different coordinate system. A star's position can be written not only in terms of x and y coordinates on an image, but in terms of declination and right ascension, which are angular coordinates. This allows us to convert the pixels in an image to arc seconds. The angle we measured is the angle formed from the two lines of sight between the Earth and the distant star. In practice, we usually call the parallax angle half of this measurement, since this gives us the benefits of dealing with a right triangle. Now that we have a parallax angle, we can use this in tangent with the distance between the star and the Earth to find the distance between our solar system and the star. Because stars are so far apart, the parallax angle will be incredibly small. That's why we measure it in arc seconds and not degrees. And the distance between the star and the Earth will be roughly the same as the distance between the star and the sun. For more on parallax angles, feel free to check out my earlier video if you haven't already. If you have questions on the technical aspects of this process, feel free to drop them in the comments. I'll also include a link in the description of an astronomer who detailed their process in full of determining parallax. Until next time, ponder, wander, and go right in the stars. In slow motion, yeah. I feel like an astronaut in the ocean, like what you know about rolling.